Today we're talking about the highly anticipated ZWO Seestar S70. There are many rumors, and in this video we will talk about it. Recently, ZWO's CEO confirmed that Seestar S70 is being developed. And from what we know so far, it's looking like a serious upgrade. Now, if you've used or seen the Seestar S50 in action, you know it made astrophotography way more accessible for more people. It was compact, easy to use, controlled entirely through an app, perfect for beginners, but powerful enough for seasoned stargazers like us too. So S70, it's taking that same philosophy and cranking it up a notch, or maybe five. Let's start with optics. The S70 is jumping from 50mm to 70mm aperture. Now, that might not sound like a huge leap, but in telescope terms, it's massive. You're essentially doubling the light gathering power. That means you can capture fainter objects like distant galaxies, nebulas, with shorter exposure time, less weighting, more detail, and sharper images. And it's not just the optics that's getting an upgrade. ZWO has confirmed that S70 will feature a brand new imaging sensor. They haven't really revealed the exact model yet, but expectations are high. We're talking about better low light sensitivity, improved dynamic range, and reduced noise, all of which are crucial for capturing clean, vibrant images of the night sky. But here's where it gets really interesting: tracking. The S70 will support an equatorial wedge. If you're not familiar with this, this allows for telescope to track celestial objects more accurately by aligning with Earth's rotation. It eliminates field rotation during long exposures, which is a common issue with alt-azimuth mounts. This is a big deal for anyone serious about deep sky imaging. There's also speculation about auto-guiding support. Now, that could mean a built-in guiding camera or compatibility with external ones. If true, it will allow for precise corrections during long exposures, something usually reserved for high-end astrophotography gear. And it doesn't stop there. ZWO might be adding wide-field imaging capabilities too. That could come from a secondary camera or even interchangeable optics. Imagine capturing the entire Milky Way in one shot, or switching to solar or lunar imaging during the day. You might even be able to use it for terrestrial photography, wildlife, landscapes, you name it. Now let's talk about who this telescope is for. Yes, it's powerful enough for serious astrophotographers, but it's also designed to be super user-friendly. That makes it perfect for schools, science centers, astronomy clubs. Imagine showing students Saturn's rings or the Orion Nebula in real time without needing a PhD in telescope alignment. The astronomy community has been buzzing with feature requests. People are hoping for all kinds of things like interchangeable lenses, built-in solar filters, support for narrowband imaging, and RAW or FITS file output for advanced editing. Some even want high frame rate support for planetary imaging. Think crisp videos of Jupiter or Mars in motion. Now let's address the elephant in the room: price. Well, nothing official yet, but the community is guessing somewhere between $800 to $1,000. Now that's a step up from the S50, but still way more affordable than premium smart telescope. So why is this such a big deal? Because smart telescopes are finally hitting their stride. More people than ever are getting into astronomy. Seestar S70 looks like ZWO's answer to that demand, a telescope that is, that blends professional grade imaging with consumer level simplicity. If it delivers on these all these promises, it could easily become the go-to scope for a huge range of users. Beginners who want to dive into astrophotography, experienced users looking for a portable companion. The bottom line is that if rumors are true, the Seestar S70 is going to be awesome. So what do you think? is the S70 something you would consider adding to your gear list? What features are you most excited about or hoping they would include? Let me know in the comments below. Until next time, clear skies.